Hi, Jörg. Wow, is that a Ponamu?
Yeah, it was a present from Angie's family. I think as a way to say sorry for the flimsy bread and the strange Nutella. Wie geht's, mein Freund?
Es geht. Look, I don't mean to cause offense, but sometimes I reckon Germans can be pretty rude, eh?
Wie meinst du das?
Ich war im Supermarkt, Jörg. An der Kasse? Oh, alles wunderbar. Aber dann... Und wie geht's dir heute? Hast du schöne Pläne für das Wochenende? And as if that wasn't bad enough, Jörg, no one came to pack my groceries.
Der Nächste, bitte.
Ja, you've made two mistakes there, Duncan.
Okay, guide me through it, Jörg.
Firstly, you've addressed an older person you didn't know with the informal
du. For Germans, this is sounding very rude. You must use the term sie. Du is for your friends or people younger than you. Secondly, in New Zealand, it is common to be making this chit-chat with the checkout persons. Which makes sense, because most people turn out to be the friend of a cousin. But in Germany, you just don't do this. It's not impolite, just different.
Yeah, this Z business just doesn't come naturally to me, Jörg.
That is because in New Zealand, you associate formality with coldness, even snobbery. Everyone is made.
But as a German, I like to make a difference between my friends and, for example on Thursday,
the bank manager.
Right, welcome to Kiwi Bank. Jörg, my name's Sharon.
Good morning, Mrs. Sharon.
No, oh, just Sharon's fine.
Do you have a second name?
Sharon's a bit formal, isn't it? Just call me Shaz. All my mates do. Cheers.
It just didn't seem very professional, Duncan. She was even telling me the whole time I had a sweet ass.
Yeah, I think she might have been saying sweet as, Jörg. It's Kiwi for not a problem.
Oh, what a shame.
Okay, mate, I'm off now.
Wiedersehen.
Ich bedanke mich herzlich bei Ihnen, gnädige Dame.
Der Nächste, bitte.